sure about that.
Here we go again. This is longer than I've got. Many people say they are aware of and know of. In fact, there was one where we lived. Water-dwelling dragons. And one lived on the mountain. I lived in Canada, way up in the volcano that had turned to a lake. And he also lived in the lakes down in the canyon, in the valley. And some say that there were passages, of water passages that went all the way through. And many Native Americans and folks in the neighborhood claimed they saw this dragon. I heard things. I never saw for sure. I heard things land on the roof that were huge. And they sounded like they had wings when they took off. Okay, when they hid in the bottom of the sea, that's why I command the serpent, and he shall bite them. And though they go into captivity before their enemies, that's why I command the sword, and it shall slay them, and it will set mine eyes upon them for evil and not for good. These are obviously not his people he's talking about. Yahweh is not the people of Yahweh. Verse 5, and Yahweh Elohim of hosts is he that toucheth the land, and it shall melt. He says these same words many times, speaking of the land melting. He also speaks of that in Hosea and some other chapters we'll look at soon. It shall melt, and all that dwell therein shall mourn, and it shall rise up wholly like a flood, and shall be drowned as by the flood of Egypt. Now this is the most interesting verse to me. Verse 6, it is he that buildeth, this is Yahweh, referring to Yahweh, it is he that buildeth his stories in the heaven, and have founded his troop in the earth. He that calleth for the waters of the sea, and poureth them out upon the face of the earth. Yahweh, Ha Elohim, Ha Yahweh is his name. The Lord is his here, so that would be with the Hebrew Ha Elohim, Ha Adonai, Ha Yahweh. So it is he that buildeth up his stories. This word stories in the Hebrew is actually means chambers above. So here we have, he buildeth up chambers above in the heaven. So there we have it, folks. And he founded his troop. In the Hebrew, this word troop is, interesting enough, a blue vault, a band in the Hebrew. A band in the chambers above, the blue band. The chambers above, chambers over, troop in the heaven, in the earth. This word in is actually over in Hebrew. His chambers above, in a band of blue vault over the earth. He that calleth for the waters of the sea and poureth them out upon the face of the earth, Yahweh is his name. The face of the earth, how many faces does a ball have? It doesn't have many faces, it's a ball. There's only one face on the planet Earth. It's the face of the earth. So it says over and over and over again in the Bible, the face of the earth. So balls don't have faces. Which one? It's all one face, you know. You can't have a face on a ball. What side would it be, you know? You would know which side to turn to. So he calleth forth the waters of the sea and poureth them upon the face of the earth. Yahweh is his name. So I found it to be a very interesting verse there, that last one. He speaks of chambers above, a blue band in the sky, and over the heaven, up in the heaven. So, yes, look at Amos chapter 9, verse 6. Very interesting verse. Might just have to print that on a t-shirt and make an artwork about it. Thanks for studying that with me. That was just a quick verse that I found of interest. I'm going to do more of those just as I come upon them. Quick verse studies. And we'll be getting back into all the other books that we're studying real soon. Maybe I'll do another one of those tonight. I've been working on my tiny today, doing some trimming of the outdoor bushes and such. My roof is starting to rain inside my roof. Quick look at my roof. I don't have plastic on my roof. I do have plastic on my roof, but the plastic is on top of these boards. It's all plastic. I don't have a real roof. And my son's cats got up there and tore it all up while I was house sitting for someone. They like to get up high, cats do. He tore it all up, and now it rained inside last night, which I was not thrilled about. Here's some verses y'all might be interested in. Close up here, I'll go to some of them. Let's run out of time. I print these up myself. If anybody's interested in purchasing them from me, I have them printed on cotton, so you can put them in your pocket and wash them. They can make great gifts. I give them away to people. And people often say, I have them choose one, and they often say, wow, this is exactly the verse I needed. I got 17 different ones. They're all promises of Yahweh. Well, I love you. Stay in the Word. Every day in the Word is a good day, because Yeshua Messiah, it's one of my paintings, Savory Island in Canada. Yeshua Messiah is the living Word. So stay in the Word. Love y'all.